Since the combat between Dan Hooker and Alec Kint is finally booked, you know, I've talked about it in one of my previous videos, Just Fight, Just Fine Please, my thoughts on Alec Kint versus Dan Hooker. The bout wasn't officially set at that time, so this is maybe the time. I don't want to repeat myself, I'd call this fight a tough guy versus tough guy, and finally, the two verbally agreed and I believe this bout will happen. And UFC 243 is one hell of a fight card, man. It takes place in Melbourne, Australia. In many fans' eyes, it's developing into something outstanding because Dan Hooker, he is the second Kiwi fighter on the list and probably the best Kiwi fighter because Israel Adesanya was born in Nigeria, but he's a Nigerian-born New Zealander. And also we have Mark Hunt, who is a legend of this sport, but he's not a UFC member anymore. Hooker, he was adamant on getting fight on the Melbourne card. And just take a look at those wonderful names, man. It's headlined by Robert Whittaker versus Israel Adesanya. I also described their beef history in one of my videos. And you know that Hooker previously told MMA Junkie that he'll be on the Melbourne fight card anyway. So he might as well have a fight. He felt good coming off a knockout victory, left hook knockout victory over James Vick in Texas. And Hooker Jacinta, there were blow exchanges on social media. Hooker was claiming that Jacinta actually turned the competition down, but Jacinta is not a fighter who turns the bouts down. I mean, that's just Al Jacinta. He's a brave guy. You know the strike he survived against Donald the Cowboy Cerrone, that knee when he went for a takedown and nothing happened. So he's a tough guy. He denied the accusations and further stated that the UFC never proposed the matchup. And according to Ariel Helwani, well, this verbal agreement is everything. They will fight, man. They will finally fight. And Dan Hooker, I already explained, he's a knockout guy. Either he's knocked out, either he earns a knockout. Alec Kint is a cardio machine, but he also stops the opponents. And you know what is the most ironical thing? The last victory from Alec Kint, it kind of came against Kevin Lee, the very same UFC Milwaukee card that Hooker was defeated, actually. It's kind of a funny thing. These pair of fighters are fan favorites due to their styles of not afraid to go on each other, and they will exchange blows. It will be an open combat. This will be a toe-to-toe war. And UFC 243, there are more stars. It's Megan Anderson. It's Taito Ivasa, who comes from a decision loss to the best Bulgarian fighter of all time, Blago Ivanov. We got Nadia Kasim. And I believe many people will watch this competition, but I will wake up in the middle of the night to watch Dan Hooker versus Alec Kint, because, you know, those two are worth watching. These are great guys, great fighters, and probably the best toe-to-toe lightweight competitors. They will fight, man. I mean, they're not the best, but they will fight. They are super entertaining, and I'm so hyped for that.